Okay, welcome to the Barroom Blitz, brought to you by Bud Light. We're bringing sports talk back to where it belongs, right here at Casey's Place. We've been gone for a long, long
12
time
years.
Again.
12
we
years.
Haven't been here since week 6 of the NFL. Obviously, technical difficulties. Jimmy's, it's usually my fault. I take blame on myself,
well,
as always.
I'm not going to blame me. All right.
Yeah, I haven't put the people in the right positions.
Yeah, I'm in the right position.
Yeah, you're in the right
I'm
position.
I'm in the right position tonight. In front of that beer.
The man that wasn't here the last time, Glenn Cheeks Keller, sitting to the side of me here.
I was not invited.
I was on
suspension.
On suspension. We have a new young gentleman down here,
yeah.
Mr. Hagenbach down here.
A graduate of Lock Haven.
Yeah.
He's a graduate?
Graduated.
About to be. In May, hopefully.
In May, all right. Well, he's going to give some added insight, some youthful perspective to
all
the program
here.
I
want to know here. About the chicks at Lock Haven.
Hey, we all want to know about that. We talk about that. That's a whole different segment.
Oh, that might need to be off camera, too.
That guy wants to know. Look
and we will have another guy to join the show later, Mr. Tim Clancy, for a Notre Dame perspective. Because you
nice
know what?
Name,
since I've done the show last, we are playing in the national championship.
Oh, God. I know. I hear all this stuff.
Yeah.
You're going to be highly disappointed, but we won't talk about that right now.
Oh, yeah. Well, we'll talk about that later. And I don't think we will be highly disappointed.
Oh, my God, please.
But talk about highly disappointed is one football season with the banner hanging behind here. The green and the midnight green and silver here. What a disappointing season. It just gets worse and worse.
What's the reason? Why? They suck.
Lack of institutional control.
Lack of institutional control. Too much loss. Lost too much leadership to bad moves. Washburn, right?
Anything you can say. You can start with the defensive coordinator job from last year. You can start with the wide nine, hiring a defensive line coach before you hire a defensive coordinator, you know, to run. Because they were talking, they said they could have got someone like Steve Spagnuolo, but he's not coming in because you already got Washburn.
It's simple. They're underachieving.
Right.
They paid all this money to everybody. And
sure, no one showed up. Vick didn't show up. All these, like, you thought you had your quarterback in Michael Vick. You thought you had your running back in McCoy. You thought you had your two wide receivers set, Macklin and Jackson. And you thought you had your all your skill positions and Selleck as your, you know, all-pro tight end. And nothing has
and
gone right.
And line with Jason Peters.
Well, you lose your line. You lost 80% of your line. You know, I mean, it's a tough.
So every team has offensive line trouble. But
right.
I mean, but they weren't that bad when they played the Giants. Remember they beat the Giants?
Yeah.
They were. I thought they had something, but I don't know. It's just the turnovers and, like you said, the injuries now, of course. But this Washburn, I don't know why you let this thing go on this long. Guy, he doesn't work with the defensive coordinator. He doesn't.
Right, they only just work by themselves.
I mean,
he was working a rotation in.
Well, that's right.
And now they got the new line coach in there, and he is like keeping guys in there longer to get in the rhythm.
Well, yeah,
like that's
I mean,
a big thing. And all of a sudden, guys are playing like Mike Patterson, and Brandon Graham.
Right.
They're all of a sudden they're showing up. Trent Cole. We had a Trent Cole sighting for the first time all year. These guys had double digits, and then they got rid of Babin, who was obviously either somewhat of a cancer in the locker room or part of the reason why Washburn's on the team and why he was on the team.
Yeah.
And they created a system that just didn't work. You know. And then I think, too, even they should have fired Mudd. They should have fired both those guys they added last year because they had this fancy dance system for linemen.
Yep.
And he got rid of all those backups. It might not have been great, but guys that we used to fill in, like a Jamal Jackson, would show up and play some games. A McGlynn. He didn't like those big, you know, loafing linemen and stuff like that.
But everyone loved them. The Washburn, the, what was it? Oh,
well
Bobby April was the greatest special team coach ever. Everybody
right.
loved him. I don't, it just
well, there's one man in control here. I don't
Andy,
know.
Andy lost
so,
a lot of his coaches left.
Right.
I remember when Jimmy Johnson lost a lot of his coaches.
Right.
You just can't replace it. You don't work the same. You know, like when Norv Turner left Dallas, their offense was never the same.
Right.
It really wasn't. And, you know, that's how it is. Jim Johnson left the Eagles.
So it's Andy's time to go, correct?
Yeah.
You can't bring him back, I think. I think it's just you dipped into the well so many times and come up with the same answer.
Do you think it's time to go?
Absolutely.
No, I think he should stay for another 10 years because I'm a Cowboy fan and keep Coleman.
I got two. Are you a Cowboys fan as well, I assume?
Keep it down.
I assume with the upbringing of a brother named Dallas. I don't know. Maybe he turned to the – maybe he saw the light.
Never.
And like the team that wins, you know, like the Patriots or something.
Tom Brady.
But
I love that.
What do you do with that? Who do you think they should go for a coach? I'm still thinking offensive coordinator from or defensive coordinator from the NFL. I do not want Chip Kelly. I don't think I don't think one of them fancy college offenses is ever going to work.
In college, but I don't think he's ready for the NFL.
Right, but I said I don't think one of them fancy, like, it's almost comparable back in the day when they had the run-and-shoot offense, and it was just like, it was hot for like 2 or 3 years, but then as soon as the defensive coordinators figure out how to beat them. It's like Cam Newton last year. They start running these little spreads, you know, college-type spread offenses, but eventually you got to learn to run the ball, play action pass, and throw it downfield.
Well, here's the thing. Who are they going to get is the thing. There's going to be a lot of openings.
I know.
At least five.
I'll tell you one college coach I would take.
Who?
O'Brien from Penn State.
Because
really? Because he has NFL credibility. He's run that offense with Tom Brady. He was the offensive coordinator. But then I guess whoever the new offensive coordinator is in New England is one of the other hot ones. But this Chip Kelly keeps popping up.
Well, the Stanford coach.
The offensive coordinator from the Patriots. He's the guy from Denver last year.
McDaniels.
Yeah, Josh McDaniels. He's the offensive coordinator.
Yeah, I don't know if we'd want him again.
I think it'd be good. I think they should get Rutgers coach.
Maybe. We'll give Wade Phillips another shot. His, like, 15th shot.
Let's play man-to-man on Tom Brady and wonder why we're down 20.
Because, you know, you have a quarterback now with the Eagles. You have a budding quarterback. What, you know, the coach, do you get a coach to work with this quarterback, or you basically just scrap the whole heap? You know,
well, when you said about Bill O'Brien, he molded Matt McGloin pretty well this year.
Right.
Looking at him last year, Matt McGloin was terrible. Now look at him now. He maybe give him a shot to get drafted. And
right. Exactly. He had a great season.
Yeah.
You know, and he turned around a program that everyone thought was dead. And I'm not going to, you know, I mean, he took a program that was basically like they deflated all the tires.
Who does he coach for? Who's this guy?
Penn State.
Bill O'Brien.
Oh, good. I like it. Bring him in. I think he sucks. Bring him in. I like it.
You don't even know who he coaches for.
I did. I forgot. I go down to the only Penn State game I ever go to, and they lose, for Christ's sake, this year. All right? So who did they lose? Florida International or something? Ohio.
It was the first game of the season.
Ohio.
They didn't even have, they only had like three. Well, I'm just
talking about a coach that, you know, that has like NFL, you know, a background in the NFL, that, you know, and you could, I mean, I know there's a buyout in there, but if you want a coach that's, you know, fresh and, you know, he obviously can work with players and change them, then he might be a guy that could work with Foles, because you're going to have to figure out what you're going to do. I don't know if he's a starting quarterback forever. You'll see, you got two more games. I mean, he's had some up games and then he's hit some bottoms. I mean, last week against the Bengals, he was throwing lollipops up there, you know, and that whole game we were leading. But, I mean, you talk about crowds and stuff, that it's just dead. Like,
strong,
it's dead.
Arm. He has a strong arm, and then he can't throw the ball 50 yards.
Well, that's what I'm saying. It was just,
and Arizona, they're pretty good.
What's that?
He was pretty good in college. His stats, he's pretty
Well, he was, yeah, but see, he was handpicked by Andy Reid. Like, Andy Reid said, I want this guy. That's what I'm saying. Like, what do you do? I mean, if Andy Reid gets a job at San Diego, do you trade him to San Diego, maybe get a draft pick back?
He can get Cobb, too, and he can have both of them.
Well, that's another thing. Andy Reid, they always talk about him as being a quarterback guru because he worked with Brett Favre. How many quarterbacks have left the Eagles and done anything?
Brett Favre. You know how
I know. Well,
don't
I
don't mention name. It's like Niagara Falls. Slowly, I turn.
I know
don't
you're turning.
Don't mention that name, Brett
I
Favre.
Know you're turning.
Jesus, God, that was such a great year. I didn't even think about Brett
I
Favre.
I am telling
and
you.
Now you got to mention Brett Favre to me.
I'm just telling you. That's his golden
chalice.
They
took the Gene commercials off and all. I was happy as
He's
shit.
He's on the Gene commercials.
No,
about
I
the
haven't
U.
seen him. I
they got the Wrangler
him.
U instead of the V-cut, man. Come on, you know it. You know it. But I am just like, so what do you do? I think if Foles would have any value, you find if Andy Reid gets that, you know, job, because they said Norv Turner's on his way out, and Andy Reid's going to slide right in there and take that job. You figure out a way to get a second round pick or another third round pick, and let your coach start over, so you clear out all controversy or clear out any headaches you could have. What would you do?
What would I? Well, the quarterbacks don't fall off the tree. Drew Brees was a dream when he was out there to be getting a couple years ago.
Right.
I would stick with Foles. He's got his foot wet.
Well, I'm saying only 1 year in the system wouldn't be too much to, you know.
Plus, I know he don't have an arm now, so that's good.
Let him get some, you know, experience under his belt and see where it goes from there.
That's my opinion, and I would get rid of Vic. Somebody will take Vic.
Oh, yeah, definitely.
Arizona probably.
Oh, Vic's done. Vic's a free agent, so who cares? You know, you don't worry about him. I'm more worried about what you do on how you handle getting a new coach or a new regime. I think you don't keep anybody. You don't get. You let that coach come in and own the whole team, like players, coaches, everything. I don't want to see half these guys back. I don't want to hear Todd Bowles' name and defensive coordinator. I don't want to hear anything. I don't want to hear Howard Mudd. I don't even want to hear the new line coach. I get them
would do it quick, though. I mean,
they should have did it. You know what? They should have did it like a couple weeks ago. Got rid of Andy Reid or let him step down.
Yeah.
And then just let someone finish out the season, and then they could have started the search. And then
I would do it quick because when they wait around, but are they going to go for a guy who's going to, you know?
Well, because you can't talk to any coaches in the playoffs.
No.
You know, if you want that guy, that's what I'm saying. You got to figure out who you want,
and I mean,
or have a game plan ready, because, you know, as teams get further in the playoffs, like that offensive coordinator, like say it's on the Denver Broncos, Manning takes them that deep. That offensive coordinator is going to be a hot prospect because all of a sudden they went from nothing, you know, switching around Tim Tebow and all that stuff, and then come back with John Fox and whoever that guy is, they're going to look that way. Like, that's what I think. You know what I mean?
Well, I mean,
it's happened even with Todd Haley in Arizona when he's hot. And, you know, they jump on those guys.
They wait for him and he goes elsewhere.
Then he went to Kansas City.
And you can't talk to him if they're coaching during the playoffs. So, they're off
so it's going to be interesting.
Then you got to wait, and you got to wait on your draft plans and all that stuff.
Well, that's it. You want to know who you want to get, because they're going to have a nice pick.
Right.
You know?
Or you got, and I don't know if you're allowed to talk to him at all, like in that off, if they're on the bye week, or if you're allowed to talk to him, and then so you can try to find his coaches too, because he's going to have to find his coaches.
Well, you got
to
get permission. First.
What we're going to get? We're going to get permission for another Bud Light.
Icy cold.
Icy cold, and we'll be right back with some more Barroom Blitz.